In my previous video on BPC-157, I got a lot of questions. In this follow-up video, I'm going to answer those questions. Now, the first question is BPC-157 a natural substance? And that question, I would say, no, it's technically not. Even though BPC-157 was isolated in the body, it was actually extrapolated from a larger segment of gastric juices. So we don't technically make it. And BPC-157 is a patented compound. So that, again, is a telltale sign that it's not technically a natural substance. Another question I got was, does topical BPC-157 work? You may have noticed that this stuff is showing up in some cosmetics and different ointments. Now, the logic for this stems from research involving animals where they purposely burned the animals and then applied BPC-157 to the skin of those animals. When they did this, the burns healed faster. This peptide also appears to have anti-inflammatory effects, which may also go to its healing properties. In case you're wondering so far, there is no evidence that BPC-157 reduces wrinkles. Now, another question I received involved whether BPC-157 could help stomach problems such as ulcers, irritable bowel syndrome, and short bowel syndrome. To be clear, there is research on this peptide and stomach problems. However, the vast majority of research, like a lot of things with this peptide, involve laboratory animals. So far, there's no evidence to my knowledge that this stuff can heal ulcers or any other stomach problems. Now, on a related question, someone else asked, do we digest BPC-157 when it is taken orally? Remember, this is a peptide. Peptides are made of amino acids. And what happens when you eat protein? They get broken down into their amino acids. So do we digest BPC-157? So what research is out there on this topic does appear to show that this peptide can survive in the stomach for up to 24 hours after it's taken orally. So while I remain skeptical on BPC-157 supplements, this is obviously good news for people who take those products. If you've been looking into this stuff, you've also noticed that there are nasal sprays containing BPC-157 as well. Do they actually work? Obviously, a nasal spray would have decided advantages over, say, injecting this stuff. So there is research suggesting that molecules weighing up to 6,000 Daltons can be absorbed intact through the nasal passages. According to the patent on BPC-157, this peptide has a molecular weight of between 900 and 1600 Daltons, which puts it right in line with something that could be absorbed through the nasal passages. So it's quite feasible that this stuff could be absorbed through a nasal spray and get effectively delivered into the body. Now, if you're an athlete, you want to listen up to this next question. Is BPC-157 legal in sports? So when I looked into this, I found a document from WADA, the World Anti-Doping Agency. In 2022, they published a document titled World Anti-Doping Code International Standard Prohibited List. And on that list, BPC-157 is indeed listed as not approved for human use. So is this peptide legal or not? Well, unfortunately, WADA does not give a reason why it's on the no-fly zone list. I really wish they would have elaborated on this more. Something else you need to know, especially if you're an athlete, is that drug tests can detect BPC-157 in the urine. But even if you're not an athlete and you are subject to random drug testing, I do suggest you speak to the companies that are doing those drug tests and ask them if they have a policy against BPC-157. So another question I got, and this one was quite interesting, is can you make your own BPC-157 from scratch? And I think this is an interesting question because we know the amino acid sequence of this peptide. So could you take these amino acids individually and let your body do all the work? So this isn't going to work for a couple of reasons. Number one, taking the amino acids by themselves individually will not force your body to produce this peptide. Like any other protein source, your body will do what it wants to with those amino acids, whether it's make a new red blood cell or repair healing or make your muscles bigger. You just really don't have any control over that. And as again, we don't make this stuff naturally, which is another reason why taking the amino acids won't work. So does BPC-157 have any side effects? Well, the animal research has been conducted, and there's quite a few of these studies out there, don't appear to show any negative harmful side effects. And that's really encouraging. But one thing I do wonder about is research suggests that BPC-157 improves angiogenesis, the formation of new blood vessels. So that makes me wonder what effect it might have on cancer, which also needs blood vessels and a blood supply to grow. To be fair, there's no evidence that BPC-157 causes cancer. However, if you have cancer, I would suggest talking to your doctor about this to get a better insight. So at the end of the day, the research appears to show that BPC-157, the peptide, appears to have a broad spectrum of effects in the body. However, we got to remember that the vast majority of that research involves laboratory animals and not humans. See my previous video on one of the human studies that has been conducted. Something else is that this peptide has been around for a number of years, which begs the question, why aren't more researchers studying it in humans? If you enjoyed this video, share it with your friends. And for more tips on dietary supplements and health and wellness, follow me here.